Welcome to Learners Academy. Today I'm taking Distinguish Between from Chapter 3 of Science 2, that is Life Processes in Living Organism Part 2 in the Quick Revision Series. I'll be giving you the best notes, and if you go by these notes, I assure you can score above 95% in science. Stay focused throughout the session and let's get started now. Let us see what is the difference between asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. This layout is given in the textbook, text back question, and I'm going to give you the same answers. But apart from that, I have even covered more points in the next slides, so you can go through them also. The first point in asexual reproduction is that it occurs with the help of somatic cells, and in case of sexual reproduction, fertilization of gametes is important, all right? Then it comes under sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction, in this case, only one parent is necessary, whereas in case of sexual reproduction, male and female parents are necessary for sexual reproduction. Now, in case of asexual reproduction, this reproduction occurs with the help of mitosis, all right? So 2n remains 2n, they don't become n haploid. All right, now in case of sexual reproduction, this reproduction occurs with the help of mitosis as well as meiosis. Next point for asexual reproduction is that new individual formed by this method is genetically identical with parents, whereas in case of sexual reproduction, new individual formed by this method is genetically different because crossing over takes place during meiosis. Alright, now in case of asexual reproduction, it occurs by different methods, like there is binary fission, there is budding as in Hydra, there's fragmentation as in Spirogyra, regeneration, vegetative propagation, alright, and there is spore formation. So there are many ways, whereas sexual reproduction happens in two steps. First is by the formation of haploid gametes by meiosis, and then fertilization of these two haploid gametes to form diploid zygote. There are no subtypes in the sexual reproduction. Now next slide, I'm going to give you even more points you can add to this. Some additional point for asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction which you can add. The first point is that in asexual reproduction, one cell divides into two, whereas in case of sexual reproduction, two cells they fuse with each other. Where in case of asexual reproduction, chromosome number is kept constant in asexual reproduction because diploid 2n condition always remains. Whereas in case of sexual reproduction, chromosome number is reduced to half. Diploid, that is 2n condition, is changed to haploid by meiosis at the time of gamete formation, and it is restored during zygote formation. Now rate of reproduction is very rapid in case of asexual reproduction, whereas rate of reproduction is slow in case of sexual reproduction. Now genetic variations are not produced in case of asexual reproduction because there is no crossing over, whereas in case of sexual reproduction, genetic variations are always produced because one set of chromosome is from male parent and one set of chromosome is from female parent, and also there is a crossing over that takes place. Alright, and in case of asexual reproduction, unicellular and lower organisms show these type of reproduction, that is for example yeast, protozoa, euglena, paramecium, amoeba. Alright, and the sexual reproduction, it occurs in higher organisms like animals and plants. Alright, what is the difference between binary fission and multiple fission? See this picture. Now in binary fission, two new individuals are formed from one old individual at one time, whereas in case of multiple fission, many new individuals are formed from one old individual at one time. In case of binary fission, the division of nucleus and cytoplasm takes place initially. All right, now only nucleus divides initially in case of multiple fission, followed by the division of cytoplasm. Now the axis of division can be transverse, it can be longitudinal, or any one axis as it is in simple binary fission. Now, in case of multiple fission, there is no exact axis for the fission. Formation of protective cis does not take place in case of binary fission, whereas in case of multiple fission, a protective covering is formed around dividing amoebally, which is called a cyst. In case of binary fission, it occurs in amoeba under favorable condition. On the other hand, multiple fissions occurs in amoeba in under unfavorable conditions. The difference between male reproductive system and female reproductive system. Testes are essential organs which are located outside the abdomen in the scrotal sacs. Whereas in case of female reproductive system, ovaries are essential organs, but they are inside the body in the lower abdomen. Now, in case of male reproductive system, urine and semen, both of them pass through the common urethra, whereas in case of female reproductive system, urethra and vagina are two separate openings. In case of male reproductive system, it works throughout his life, whereas female reproductive system works only till the menopause occurs in female, which is usually from 45 to 50 years of age or maybe later. Now, in case of male reproductive system, sperms or gametes are produced by meiosis in the testes, whereas oocytes or ova are produced by meiosis in the ovaries in case of female reproductive system. Next point is sperms are produced in millions at one time. Only one single oocyte is produced per month in case of female reproductive system. Now, three accessory glands are associated with male reproductive system, and in case of female, only one gland is associated with female reproductive system. Last point is testes secretes testosterone, which is essential male hormone, whereas ovaries produces ovary produces estrogen and progesterone, which are essential female hormones. So now you can see the picture of male reproductive system and female reproductive system. See, this is a scrotal sac, and the urethra is common in case of male reproductive system, whereas you can see here the vaginal opening and urethral opening are different. And you can see on both the side there is ovary. So that was all the difference between male reproductive system and female reproductive system. What is the difference between monozygotic twins and dizygotic twins? So when two children developing from one zygote, then they are called monozygotic. On the other hand, if two children develop from two different zygote, they are called dizygotic twins. Monozygotic twins develop from the same oocyte, whereas dizygotic twins, they develop from two different oocytes. That means two oocytes have been fertilized during the intercourse, and definitely when there are two sperms fertilizing the oocytes, they can be different sex also. So one child can be a male, the other can be a female. There is a possibility. Whereas in case of monozygotic twins, gender of both the twins is same, because this thing happens, the division happens after fertilization. So only one sperm had fertilized the oocyte, and later on it has got divided into two. So the gender of the both of the twins will be same in case of monozygotic twin, whereas in case of dizygotic twin, gender of both the twins can be same or can be different. All right, there is a possibility. Now, in case of monozygotic twins, they are genetically exactly alike, because it is one oocyte and one sperm that was fertilized. Now the zygote was formed, and after that there was a division. So they will be genetically exactly same. Whereas the zygotic twin, dizygotic twins, are genetically not exactly alike. So that was the difference between monozygotic twins and dizygotic twins. I hope you enjoyed watching the video and learned how to answer distinguish between two phenomena. If you want to see more of such videos, subscribe to my channel and take a look at Learners Academy page. And if you have any queries, leave your comments in the comment section. Keep learning, share your knowledge widely with your friends. Thank you for watching and have a wonderful day.